Hippie, c'est un nouveau groupe. Selon les rockers canadiens, après 3 albums en 3 ans, il était grand temps de se réinventer. Ils ont donc fait appel au réputé producteur Bob Rock, qui leur a donné le coup de pied dans le derrière dont le groupe avait besoin. Après s'être enfermés en studio à Hawaï, ils nous ont présenté cet été l'album Gravity.
First word I heard, or the loudest word I heard before, was balls.
Balls.
What's up with that?
Balls, Bob.
Rob's Rock came in, and the first time we met him, we were playing, just plugged in, played a few songs, and he comes in, and he's all excited. He's like, you guys, such a great rock band. You just need a little bit more balls. And he grabs his balls.
Yeah.
And that was it. That was enough for us. And we said, can we make a record with you, please?
Because of the balls.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Yes.
I remember feeling low. I remember losing hope. And I remember all the feelings and the day they stopped.
Tell me more about the recording process. Maui, I know you guys said it was to get away from distractions, but I would say that, you know, with the beach and Bob Rock's here,
well, I mean,
there's a lot of distractions. You know, the good ones, I don't know.
We're all musical, you know. It's like everything in Maui is about keying yourself up and preparing yourself to go in the studio and just be totally chill and enjoy making music. We're in Toronto, and we made records here. Man, it's like family, friends, girlfriends, whatever. You know, there's management, record label, all this other crap. And out there, we were totally isolated. And we lived in the same house, cooked meals together, drove to the studio together, surfed together, became a real family, you know? It's like this, it's a complete rebirth of the band.
Stuff.
Yeah, that's why. It's like after a while, the heaviness, it just, you know, it starts to like weigh you down and drag you down a bit. And it just felt like that album was overshadowed, became overshadowed by the book and by, you know, the themes, the heavy themes. And it's like, it's fine for like 18 months to be on that wavelength. But man, I don't want to talk about that book for another 10 years.
We were just interested in becoming a rock band again and simplifying it and getting down to 10 great songs on a record that you can sit down and listen to all the way through.
It's like Back in Black.
Yeah. Yeah. Not to discredit anything that we've done before, but it just, we wanted to simplify, and I think we were just so excited about feeling like a young band again. I think that infectiousness has caused this record to happen.
Roll camera.
Hey.
Roll playback.
Satellite. I'm waiting for the sky to fall. I'm waiting for a sign.
Let's roll the video playback, please.
Well, this guy must have helped as well.
Huge.
Damn right.
How did you find each other? All of you.
Mutual friend.
Mutual friend?
I was playing in a band with a friend of theirs, and Jeremy called him up when they had split up with Mike and said, do you know anyone you think would be good for the band? Because we're looking for a new guitar player. It's like, he said, yeah, this guy I'm playing with.
Look at the sparkle in his eyes when he's telling the story. He's like, and then they called me.
Yeah.
And then we played, you know?
Yeah,
and
man.
So were you were a fan of the band before?
Yes, big fan.
What is going through your head when they like pull the curtain and like Wizard of Oz, Bob Rock is standing there and he's going, plays?
Yeah, it was a trip. It was a trip because the situation alone, no matter where we would have been a trip. And that's sort of like, okay, we're in Hawaii and this guy over here is Bob Rock. It's sort of like extra little interesting factor.
With these songs, that the 10 songs that are on the record, would they they come in, you know, collective verse? Would you come with lyrics? Would you guys come with music? Are they mostly, you know, a couple takes and that's it, they're done? Because that's what it feels like when you listen
to it. Yeah, the most common thread is the fact that we all sat in a room and played together, you know, and there's a song, Bring Back the Sun, which was recorded completely live off the floor. The vocals are live. All we did was add strings. And that's the first time that's ever happened. But that's the idea of the whole record, was we were all in one room recording. And, you know, Rain brought in a bunch of his own songs. And we all kind of took those songs and worked together to make them Our Lady Peace songs, as well as songs that we wrote together in the room. Mm-hmm. You know,
it was just
I mean?
Really easy, you know. It was just...
Well, it sounds like simplifying
too easy.
The process.
Yeah, the way Bob arranges stuff, it's like it's... You play it as a rock band, and that's it. And if it doesn't sound good just the four of us playing it, then it's not even worth putting on tape.